People, this is going to get a little graphic, but I was going to show y'all how to dress a turtle. I've already taken the head off of it, but this is what I grew up eating right here. This is still my favorite meat out there, and we're going to do another segment on cooking it in just a little bit. So cut just a little bit right there. We were watching a video the other day and somebody didn't cut this part of it. I always cut this part of it all the way around. Got different ways of doing it. I'm sure people's got faster ways of doing it. It's been a little while since I've done one, so. That stuff's like leather. This is what you need to make your boots out of right here. Be a small pair of boots, but. Look, you can see it moving right there. So you should be able to stick your knife right there and cut around. When you're ready. Like the skin of an armadillo. Ooh, I left a little money on the table right there. Not good. Leave the fat with the turtle. We don't want turtle fat. You cut every inch of this thing. You don't pull. They're tough. Huh. I thought I was all the way out there, but I'm not.
I think it'll be fine.
Hard to break. All we do is trim the fat on this bad boy right here. You know, just clean it up like stuff like this. Just cut this off. But see, that's white meat right there. That whole neck is. Not too bad for a small snapping turtle. All right, we got an onion, garlic, and bacon. We're gonna fry this. We're gonna fry this down. What we got? We got our onions right here. We're cooking those down. Got the bacon in there. Got the garlic in there. And let me tell you, that right there is smelling good enough to eat already. We got this stock from this chicken. And it's got Dale's, and of course, it's got garlic and probably onion powder and everything else in it. Did put some Creole seasoning on these onions and that bacon right there. We got a rolling boil going right here. Let's drop that turtle in there real quick. Anytime you add bacon to something makes it a whole lot better, so let's try this right here. Just, I'm gonna brown up some flour. I'm cooking up some biscuits. Well, I'm cheating. Not homemade this time, I ain't got time. About to starve to death, haven't had breakfast this morning, so this is gonna be breakfast right here and lunch. So I'm going to brown up some flour, and I'm going to put it in here. This has been cooking for probably, I don't know, 1.5 to 2 hours. It's getting pretty tender. So that's the plan, y'all. That's what we're going to do. Instead of gumbo, we're going to stick with the brown gravy. It is delicious. The whole house smells like just, smells fantastic. When you're browning flour, you gotta really watch it. I'm talking about it will burn, it'll scorch in just a second. So I got it on high heat. I need to turn it down just a tad. When it starts browning though, you gotta keep it moving. Now I put about a cup in here, maybe a little bit more than a cup. Make it as brown as you want.
falling off the bone, so we're about right.